Kind of like what we saw in game number one, like Sullivan talked about, a momentum swings. Here comes Tanev driving in, stopped by Varlamov. On the diving effort from Tanev, and now the Islanders take exception, and hopefully Tanev is okay.
Yeah, and I don't know ultimately what they're going to call here, but you can't push the goaltender over, even with your momentum. Varlamov looked like he had that puck, and Tanev just continued on his way as he had to extend himself. He really left himself vulnerable as he extended towards that puck. He had no other choice. He had a head of steam. He had one direction that was north. And he extends himself. He's able to jab the puck towards Varlamov and then go straight into the net and right into the goaltender. And this, if it didn't heat up earlier, it's heating up now. Here we go.
And now Matt Martin.
Martin's grabbing a hold of Zach Aston-Reese, I believe.
It is Aston-Reese. Are they going to go? The gloves remain on.
And the referee's watching intently. None of these combatants here want to take the extra penalty. You got to be careful.
Right.
You take that first shot and the other guy turtles on you or something, you're going to the box. And you don't want to do that in a 2-1 game. That's why Martin left the gloves on. Listen, both of them would have scrapped. Martin certainly.
You're going to step aside and the officials will sort this all out. After scoring chance for Brandon Tanev, what an effort. It's 2-1 Pittsburgh.
Semyon Varlamov, as he had to extend himself, and in doing so, slides into Varlamov, who's just coming back from a lower body injury. You see the puck goes over the goal line. The referees took a look at it, but he wasn't pushed in. You can't push the goaltender in like that if he has the puck on his pad or under his glove. So there won't be an argument here. Had he been pushed in, you may have had yourself an argument.
The calls are Martin and Aston-Reese, two each for roughing here at 15:03. So we go back to 4-on-4 hockey.